I'm Koaw, this is KN Fish and Smarts, where we fishers are always learning and sharing knowledge about fishing and fishes. And here you are watching a feeding frenzy on a failed carp bait that is peanut butter based. I just took the rest of this bait down to a pool in a Virginia creek and put a camera on it. So this video is more of a channel update video, as well as me sharing a few important things I learned during my first season as a carp fisher. So let's get these updates out of the way. Firstly, our KNFS video releases have been a bit slow because I've been on the IR list for most of this fall, as two discs in my spine decided to move out of place when I was fishing in Michigan, and it's put a big wrench in my fall fishing plans and video plans for KNFS. So some videos I promised will be delayed, possibly until the spring. That's just how life goes sometimes. Secondly, next Friday I'll be releasing a video on optimizing play height for the drop shot. This video has some important fishing concepts that could benefit any fisher, not just those fishing the drop shot. I also programmed a couple of very basic drop shot fishing simulators for y'all that'll be free to use, and I'll introduce them in that video on Friday. But here in this creek, it's just really cool seeing these fish and how they're demolishing this bait. And it's interesting seeing how these common shiners just zip through, while the creek chubs have a more passive approach. So carp wise, I landed just under 100 pounds of carp this season, with my biggest weighing just over 16 pounds. And I made at least 10 different carp baits for this season and presented them a number of different ways. I even made boilies a few times. And that'll be my first bit here. Good protein baits are great for the chum and grounds. Corn is great, but I found the carp would stop showing up to my chumming grounds after about a week. Boilies changed that for me. Boilies take some serious time to make, but I definitely saw more carp and other fish just willing to hang around the chum spots with the boilies, which were all healthy mixtures of protein and fat. That's good food for fishes. I mixed in koi food I picked up at the pet store to supplement the baits, though I still never caught my koi. Turtles also loved boilies, really. Turtles showed up like crazy around all my carp baits, and they loved the boilies. So though not intentionally going for turtles, I caught about as many turtles this season on my carp rigs as I did carp.
It's right in your bottom lip, Dad. Nope, don't bite my pliers. Gee, that wasn't so bad.
Like I said, I tried a number of rigs and presentations, including these foam floaters with some scent I put on them, but I never landed a carp with this technique. What worked for me was just the standard method feeder with a basic hair rig, and even a KD rig worked for me. And that right there is a big old snapping turtle. I did hook this guy on another day, but luckily he shook free when he snagged my anchor line. So, is scent worth it? Well, I landed big carp with and without scent. But I will say that I definitely landed more species of fishes, as well as more fish in general, with scent on. Though my data is very limited to only this season, I'll probably stick with scent from now on. Get some rod holders. If you saw the video of my first adventure on my first day carp fishing, when I landed that one carp on the broken rod, you'll know it happened because I didn't have it in a holder. And even with a fairly loose bail set on that reel, the carp just moved the rod into a bad position. So I've built my own rod holders for sure. And then I've got a modified one on the raft boat. And they work great. I can't trust the stick in the mud anymore. If you've yet to find a trustworthy carp hook, then let me just recommend the Gamakatsu g-carp specialist RXs. These things are strong and they stay sharp, and I remember in an Illinois river, just before I caught this guy, I snagged a submerged log that must have weighed 100 pounds. It took me a while to work the whole rig in without snapping my line, but the hook didn't even bend. I'm not joking. And after I got off the log, it was still sharp enough to hook this carp. So you can see this yellow bullhead is spitting this fake horn right now. That's not a Gamakatsu G-Carp Specialist RX. That's actually a Gamakatsu Micro Perfect Gap that I modified to be offset to see if I could land any of the large white suckers in this creek. Well, obviously that didn't work. It didn't even work hook setting on these catfish here. The mod failed. But that's not to say the Micro Perfect Gap hooks are bad. I love them. That's when I'm able to do my own hook sets. But those G-Carp Specialists self-set on plenty of yellow bullheads. Size 4 and size 2 were what I think I caught them on. Even small catfish have big mouths. And, I mean, that's one way we learn, trying new things. I try something new almost every time I'm on the water. And I'll tell you what, my experiments fail probably 95% of the time. But in each one of those failures, I learn something new. And anytime I get a camera underwater, I'm also learning something new. Observing fish behavior is just such an invaluable resource. Like here, one thing just to pick up is that the smaller fish will shred your carp baits. And that's good in that they are releasing all of that scent into the water that will eventually get picked up by the nostrils and barbels of carp. And it's also bad in that you still want some bait sitting around besides the fake horn or other bait on your hook. Experience always is the best teacher. But I know I also learn so much from other anglers. Just listening to their experiences and watching how they play certain techniques is an opportunity for me to improve my own fishing game. And yeah, sometimes we have to sift through the BS from certain anglers, but I truly believe that almost every angler has something valuable to teach another angler, be it an experience, a technique, a modification, whatever. So I know some of you have already put up your fishing gear for the oncoming winter and not bringing it out till spring, but for those of you who haven't, I say fish responsibly and good luck.